What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exotic Astrology again, and today I'm with the new microphone, Blue Snowball ICE. So I'm very sure that this audio is fabulous. It is much better than the other audio which was there in the earlier videos. So congratulations, now you will be hearing much better. All right, if you're new to the channel, then subscribe to it below, and if you like this video, then click the thumbs up and share it with everybody else. And today, what is the topic? Today's topic is the most beautiful planet. Which is the most beautiful planet? Maybe it is one of the four natural benefics, right? Who are the four benefics? Jupiter, Venus, Moon, Mercury. Among them, who is the most benefic? Benefic is known as the word Soumya. Soumya means that which gives you things easily. That means, as per Parashara, Venus is the most Soumya. It is the most benefic of all, even more benefic than Jupiter itself. But am I going to talk of Venus today? When I say the most beautiful planet, I do not mean Venus. I do not mean even Jupiter. I do not even mean Ketu. I do not mean Rahu. I do not mean Moon, Mercury. Then who is remaining? Maybe the Sun, right? No, it is not the Sun. Then who is remaining? The Sun of Sun. Yes, you are right. It is Saturn itself. The most beautiful planet. The most cherished planet. The most misunderstood planet. What has happened over the course of astrology, especially in India? The planets like Saturn, Mars, Rahu, Ketu have become villains, and everybody goes and blames them for the different sufferings that they probably or apparently make the native go through. But let us understand what is the reality. Why is it that the planet, especially Saturn, gives us suffering? Rahu gives us more of cheating and tendencies to do things for only ourselves, selfishness, etc. Ketu takes away things from us abruptly, but Saturn will always give you warnings. But let us understand, why does Saturn give us struggles? Why does Saturn give us suffering at all, if you call it a suffering? Because Saturn was the son of Surya Narayan. He is the son of the sun, sun god. And due to some reason, he was abandoned by the sun. That means he was not given his proper rights, proper share, proper due. And that is why he doesn't get along with his father very well. Because of which, he suffered terribly. And he also limps. Therefore, he is the only planet which does not want others to suffer. Should I repeat? Saturn is the only planet, perhaps, which does not want you to suffer like he suffered. And what happens is, when Saturn gives you suffering, it is simply a wake-up call. For example, there are many people who run their Sade Sati or their Saturn Mahadasha or the Saturn Antardasha. If you do not know what is Mahadasha and what is Antardasha, I will make a video later, but now simply it means that in Vedic astrology there is something called as Dasha, which means the time period of a particular planet when that planet becomes the most prominent planet in the chart. Every planet exists eternally in the chart for a person, but for some certain period of time that planet becomes the most important planet. And there is something called as Sade Sati, about which we all know, right? What is Sade Sati? When in transit, Saturn goes over your natal moon, 12th from it and over it and second from it. 2.5 years, 2.5 years and 2.5 years is total 7.5 years. So when Saturn is 12th from your moon till it is in the second house, that is the time period of your Sade Sati. That is why Sade Sat in Hindi is 7.5 years. So 2.5, 2.5, 2.5 is total 7.5 years. So whenever somebody is undergoing time periods of Saturn, that is Dasha of Saturn, or periods like Sadesati, then it is seen that they suffer very much. And nowadays, astrologers may say that, oh, Sadesati doesn't act, Sadesati is just an illusion. Well, maybe for them it is, but in my experience, in my practical experience and in my research, I have seen that people suffering in Sadesati. Because that is the time when you feel the mental pressure. Otherwise, the world is not that bad. Whatever happens to you during Sadesati will affect you very much mentally. If it is some other time, then it will not affect you very much internally. For example, if you have got a minor accident, then what happens? Nothing. You just go to the hospital and you get cured. But now when Sadesati is going on, it doesn't happen like that. Everything will attack you mentally. More than the physical, it is the mental, because mental things get to the head, right? And that is why they say Sadesati gives you troubles, or you are in trouble during Sadesati. And depending on the Ashtakvarga points which Saturn is contributing, and the Bhinna Ashtakvarga, etc. I will discuss on Ashtakvarga later. And the position of Saturn in your natal birth chart, and the dignity of Moon in your natal birth chart, and the planets conjunct Saturn or Moon, the Sadesati is either difficult or very difficult or worse, or it can be very good also. We will see later about Sadesati in detail. What I am trying to say here is, these are the specific time periods related to Saturn when people suffer. Other periods when Saturn makes you suffer is wherever Saturn is sitting, or whichever planet it is aspecting. For example, if Saturn is sitting with Venus, then it is seen that marriages get delayed. If Saturn is sitting with Sun, then it seems that your money, your prospects of career, your achievement, your success, these things get delayed. If Jupiter, Saturn are sitting together, it can show that spirituality and spiritual life gets delayed. You need to work very hard for spiritual upliftment. Even children and coming of children can get very much delayed with Saturn and Jupiter. Now, as I said, Saturn is the only planet which does not want you to suffer. There is no other planet among all the other planets which does not want you to suffer. Not that they all want you to suffer, but the tendency of natural benefits like Jupiter, Moon, Mercury, Venus is that they give you things which you want and which they signify. And they signify all the good things in life. Jupiter signifies children, family, expansion, growth, money, spirituality, wisdom. Venus signifies wife, sexuality, husband in a man's chart, luxury, romance, love, creativity, fun, etc. Mercury signifies friends, relatives, communication, etc. And Moon represents your home, your mother, your comforts, all right. So these are the things basically everybody wants in life. But Saturn is the only planet which wants that you be happy. Because the natural benefits, even if they may be benefits, not necessary that whenever you have all those things, you are happy. Not necessarily always, because there are many people who have very great relationships, but they are not happy, they are miserable. There are many people who have a lot of money, but they are committing suicides. Why is it like that? Because they do not understand the ultimate goal of life. What is the ultimate goal of life? The ultimate goal of life is to obtain spiritual perfection. Therefore, the planet Saturn is the only planet which gives you this realization that you will not be happy in this world. Because the time and again, the scriptures, especially scriptures like the Bhagavad Gita, tell us, they remind us that this world is a place of misery, dukhalayam ashashvatam. And if we want real happiness, it is surely available, but not in this material realm. It is available in God. It is available in the Almighty, beyond this material realm, because we all are living beings and we are souls. We are not bodies trying to enjoy things here. We can do that for some time, but it will not give us ultimate happiness. Therefore, Saturn is the only planet which shakes us from our illusions for our dreams and puts us into reality. For example, if Saturn is seeing that you are in a relationship just for the sake of being in a relationship with somebody, then when your Sare Sati starts, or when the time of Saturn comes as Padasha, you will let go of that relationship, or you will be forced to. I have seen people time and again, during the time period of Saturn or in their Sare Sati, it gets worse for them. Because what Saturn is doing is, Saturn is trying to tell you that, look, my dear sir, you are in this relationship, but is it giving you real happiness? Is it giving you fulfillment? Is it giving you contentment? Is the purpose of staying in the relationship getting fulfilled? If it is not, well then, if it is a very superficial relationship, you are uploading photos in Facebook and Instagram, and oh, we have such a great relationship, we are the best couple in this world. Alright, then Saturn says, alright, let's see how much strong is your relationship. And then Saturn will test you, it will put you into hurdles. And if you have a good relationship, if your marriage is good actually, if there is element of sacrifice and understanding and commitment, then after the challenges which Saturn offers, your relationship will come out in a new phase. It will be a beautiful one. It will be a much better relationship than it was earlier. And if you cannot go through it, that means there is lack of sacrifice, or there is lack of commitment, there is lack of understanding, and then you finally have to let go of the person. If you do not believe me, just go and check. Anybody, I am saying, blind dictum, anybody who has suffered during their Saturn's time period or Sare Sati, they were simply on the superficial plane. For example, if you are in a great job, so-called, apparently if you are in a big job, big paying job, but you hate it, you don't like it, or you are pretending that, oh, that's such a great job, I am in such a big company like Google, Microsoft, BCG, McKinsey, whatever you call it. And then you are uploading photos in Instagram, you are uploading photos here, you are uploading photos there, and then you are traveling due to some reason, and then Saturn's time comes and Saturn checks, is it really true? Then if it is not so great for you, if it is not going that great, then Saturn will force you to leave that job. And similarly, if you are studying, if you are doing some preparation, it is best to have Saturn's time, because then Saturn will keep you grounded. Saturn will show you that, look my dear sir, you have to work hard, you will not get things that easily the way you expected. And I have seen during the time of competitive exams, if the period of Saturn comes, especially in India, the people prepare for exams like UPSC, Union Public Service Commission, which is for government exams, which are very competitive. Only if you have the time period of Saturn, only then you work very hard, and then you will definitely earn success. Take it from me, this is my word, you will earn success. And there are people who, recently I made a video, those people who have a big problem. If you have not seen it, then go and see, big problem. Who are the people who have big problem all the time? Those people who are puffed up with their ego, with their pride, bragging constantly, not directly, humble bragging, like in Hindi they say na, hamara to aisa hai, waisa hai. You know, actually mine is like that, I am doing this also, I am doing that also, yeah, actually I have given an application to Google, let's see, yeah, people have got actually, now maybe I will also get, maybe you get, that's great, but what if you don't get? So those people only suffer in Sare Sati. Those people who are puffed up with their ego, who are puffed up with their false pride, those people who have a higher conception of themselves than what they have. For example, if a girl is good looking, but if she thinks that she is the queen of the town, she is the Cleopatra, or she is the Lady Diana of this time, then Saturn will tell you, my dear madam, you are definitely good looking, but Not that great also. And on the basis of that so-called beauty, if you humiliate other people, if you denigrate others, if you look down on others, you may not do it directly, but through your subtle actions, if you convey anything like that, or if you try to hint somebody that, okay, you know, you are not that great as me, you don't look that great as me, then I will tell you what will happen. That thing because of which you are proud, people will leave you for that reason itself. For example, if a girl is very proud of her beauty, it's great to be beautiful. There's nothing wrong in having beauty. But if you are obsessed about it, if you are too much into it, if that has become the definition of your life, then, well, let me tell you, you are inviting disaster. What will you do if you have that kind of an attitude? You will go on a rampage, savaging everybody. Especially, I have seen good-looking girls, they will call the other girls who are not that good-looking by different names. For example, I have a friend, she's very good-looking. Probably she's watching this video also. So then one day she told me that she is going to a place, to a restaurant to eat with one of her friends. Then I asked her, what is her name? Then she said, so-and-so. And then she said, yeah, this Moti is coming. Moti means in Hindi, in English it means a girl who is very fat, obese. I don't know, fat or obese, however you call it, overweight. Means doesn't look very good, has a lot of fats in her body. And the way by which she said, that was not proper. Everybody makes fun of people who are not good looking, but the way, the attitude with which she said, I understood that she is going to suffer during her Saturn's time period. And how will she suffer? Well, I don't know. Well, how will she suffer? But I have seen these kind of people. They suffer because of the reason which they are proud of themselves. There's another friend who I know. She is from a very rich family, from a family connected to governments, royal authorities, royal leaders. So wherever she will go, she will only brag. Okay, my grandfather was this, my father was this. Madam, can you please also show me what you have done? But anyways, I am not concerned about these people because I know. When the time of Saturn comes, they will suffer. They will terribly suffer. Whichever thing you are proud of, Saturn will show you that, look, my dear sir, you are good but not that great. And that's good for you. That will bring humility. Humility is the ultimate gift of Saturn. And unfortunately in this world, people do not become humble by good ways. They will only become humble by learning lessons. Unless one is thrashed and humiliated, he or she will not learn humility. Unless one undergoes humiliation, he does not learn humility. And in fact, there are people who I know who even don't learn that after facing humiliation. That's terrible, actually. That's the worst part. So therefore, the video is on the most beautiful planet. The most beautiful planet is Saturn himself. And he doesn't want that because of superficial reasons, like being proud of something which will be taken away from you. For example, if somebody is proud of his or her beauty, how long is the beauty going to stay? Till the age of 30, 40? Okay, you may say, I will keep makeup, but what after some time? Well, what will happen then? So Saturn will tell you that, look, my dear sir or madam, the beauty which you are very proud of will not stay with you very long, because you will get old one day, you will also get wrinkles. How long will you hide your... How long are you going to hide the things that you know? So instead of that, Saturn will give you humility. Maybe somebody will insult you. There was a girl who I knew. She told me once, she contacted me for a consultation, and she told me that I was the most beautiful girl in my college. But the boy who I was in love with, he ditched me. He cheated on me. He went away with another girl. And the funny part is, see, whenever there are cases like this, what happens? Everybody will blame the boy, right? that the boy is a rascal, he's wrong, he's a cheater, you should kill him, you should punish him, he's torturing women. Generally people say like that. But what happened in this case was, it's very funny. The same boy who cheated on this girl, who was apparently the most beautiful girl in her college, from last 11 years, he is in a committed relationship with the other girl, and now he's getting married with the girl. And this, the girl told me, the girl who got cheated, she told me that, I don't understand, if this person cheated on me, then how is he not cheating on that girl? And the boy who cheated, I don't know, I have not talked with him, but she had sent me his horoscope, and he looks to be a good person. I'm not saying that what he did was correct, but what I'm saying is, sometimes it may happen that good people also cheat you. And they will not cheat anybody else. With everybody else they are good, but only with you they have some issue, some karma. So then you should understand that my time is on lessons, okay? So she was obsessed with her status as the most charming lady of her college. And can you imagine, this boy cheated on her for a girl who is not that charming like her. And when I checked, she was running her Sade Sati period. She was running it. And she said, that instance transformed me, because I thought that beauty can keep anybody. But then I was so wrong. It doesn't happen. It doesn't work that way. It has never worked. It doesn't work, and it will not work like that. Alright, that is it from my side. So, next time when you go to a temple of Lord Shani, Saturn, or it is a Saturday, or it is the days like 8 or 26 or 17, because 8 is the number of Saturn, or it is Saturday, then maybe you can thank Saturn that whatever you have given me, I will try to keep it, and I will learn the lessons from that. And ultimately what happens is, Saturn will show you your reality, show you your limits. And that is why when the time of Saturn comes, or when Saturn's Sade Sati starts, you will see people leaving you. You will become very much internal. You will not want to show too much in Facebook. Because Saturn will tell you, Saturn will give you such terrible depression if you are doing all those things. If you are hovering on the surface, if you are in that Rahu phase, showing people how great you look, how great your relationship is, how great your career is, bragging about things that you don't have any contribution in, then Saturn will show you the reality. And if you are having superficial relationships with people who actually should not be in your life, then let me tell you, Saturn will take them away from you, which is very good for you actually. That is why during the period of Saturn, you will find people deleting numbers from their contact list. And you will find those people with whom you had trust, they will not reply to you properly. This is what people tell me, that, oh, my friend is not replying to me. He or she is not messaging me. How come suddenly they are not messaging you? Not that they are not messaging. Saturn is showing you, it is time you let go of these people. These are superficial people. They are not going to help you. They are only going to simply waste your time. That is why, kick them out of your life. Stay away from them. Do not waste time with them. That is why I have seen so many girls. They will upload selfies with the tag best friend. And what happens when Saturn's time comes? Bang! One thing and things go haywire. Some clash is there. Some fight somewhere, something. And then they are not best friends anymore. They are not the darling of the dreams anymore. So things are not that great, you see. So ultimately, one who is humble, he does not suffer in the time period of Saturn. Let me repeat. One who has humility will not suffer. Should I repeat again? H-U-M-I-L-I-T-Y. If you think you know everything, if you think you know too much, well then Saturn will tell you, he will give you some humiliation, open public humiliation. Then your ego will be smashed because Saturn doesn't like the sun. So when Saturn sees you have sun's element ego, he will ensure that you come in the ground. So do not force Saturn to teach you lessons which he wants to teach you. Learn the lesson before. Bring humility. Stay in the ground. Be realistic. Respect everybody. Do not mistreat anybody. Respect everybody. Do not mistreat, because Saturn gets exalted in the sign of Libra. Libra is what? Other people, everybody, balanced. Do not be partial. Be impartial. Alright. Do good for everybody. Stay happy. If you are new to the channel, then subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the like button. And if you are interested to do some donation, then you can go to PayPal and do. Or else share this video with everybody else. Until next time, I will stop the video now. Wish you great luck with Saturn. Hope that he teaches you the lessons or you learn it before itself. Okay. Until next time. Bye-bye. See you.